Hey, it's Andy here. Welcome back to part two of this lesson of singing and playing at the same time. The particular thing that we're looking at here in this lesson is getting your lyrics as easy to read as possible. It seems like an obvious thing, but a lot of people get tripped up by it. So to recap from part one, the things that we've learned so far are that we're going to, instead of simply printing out our lyrics from where we find it from our search online, we're going to copy and paste that into a word processor, that so that from there we can do some edits to make it easier to read. So the first thing I mentioned was you're going to make your header large, bold, and make it colored. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to bold your chorus to make it easy to spot. As well as that, you're going to insert line breaks where you want, or you can even take away line breaks if there are line breaks there. You're making it easy to scan through with your eyes quickly, because in a lot of situations where you're performing, you're not going to have ideal lighting. It's nice to think that you will, but it's not always the case. Even if you've got a little light that goes, you know, goes with you everywhere that you can put over things, that can blow whatever else. You want to make it as easy as possible. So those are the things that we've looked at so far. The next thing I want to aid you with to make it easier is often you've got to deal with the situation of a lyric sheet going over more than one page. That isn't an option for guitarists. Maybe if you're a piano player who's got a page turner, but that's that's not real for a guitarist. You've got to do everything yourself. That hand's playing guitar, that hand's playing the guitar as well. So we've got to squish it all in, but how can we do that without losing lyrics? Well, the first thing I suggest that you do is if you have repeated lines, which are the same thing over and over and over again, often you'll get this in the outro of a song where it's singing a chorus line over and over. In this case, the line in this song is, "I know, I know, I know what is inside." And it does that four times. So instead of having that typed four times, which is often what you'll find, or however many times it is, you're going to knock off all of them apart from the first one and simply place on the end of it, as I've done here, times four. And that way we bring all of this spill from the second page up onto the first page. Now, you may still have spill going onto the second page. Another thing that you can do that I always do, even if I haven't got spill, because it's just easy on the eyes. Remember, this is the whole context. We're making things easy to look at, non-complicated. Is if you have multiple choruses, instead of having the chorus written out again, we're going to take that same concept and make it simple. We're just going to write chorus instead of having those same lyrics written out. And that's going to save you, in this case, I actually haven't even written on this one because I know that the chorus comes up there. I know the song pretty well already, but if it's a new song to me, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all those lyrics and just type chorus there and make that bold. And that saves you a lot of lines as well. So with those two things combined, that will generally squish everything back onto one page for you. All right, the next thing is your font. The font is a very important thing in making your text easy to read. A lot of people wouldn't even think about this. There's been studies done, and Times New Roman, whatever it's called, is the easiest text for your eye in the sense of reading through fast, skimming through, or low light, that sort of thing. Supposedly, it is the easiest on the eye. Now, personally, I like Arial, or Arial, however you want to pronounce it. And I put all of my lyrics into Arial because I find them the easiest to look at when they're in that font. It's up to you. But between those two, that's what I suggest. Often you'll get lyrics in all sorts of interesting fonts. And you're not aiming for pretty here. You're aiming for effective. You don't want to get, caught in the middle of a song, not able to read your lyrics properly, and going, oh, at least they look pretty, you know. It doesn't stack up. So you want to make your lyrics as easy to read as possible. So Times or Arial. And then the final one is, once you've done all of that, you want to make the text as big as possible, which is for logical reasons. You want to, you know, again, it's down to that non-ideal lighting and just making things easy for yourself. So what you're going to do, you're going to select everything and you're going to blow it up until you notice that you have the longest line on here start spilling over to a new line. So in this case, all the lines are pretty even, so I just got to blow that up until it got to the edge there. In the case of this this song that I was showing in the first part of the video, you'll notice in the middle, there's that one line, or two lines there, that are a whole lot longer than the others. So what I would suggest you do there is find the sort of middle point in the phrasing and just bump it down onto a new line. So you're cutting it in half, effectively. That way you can then take this, because this is only taking up a little over half a page, and you can blow it right up to fill heaps more of the page, and you haven't got such tiny text there. So that is the big final point for making your lyrics easy to read. And once you put all those into action, trust me, it seems like a lot of stuff in the explanation, but this takes me normally between 2 and, if it's really busy and I need to look through the phrasing and do lots of things, 5 minutes at the most. If you're going to be using these lyrics for, especially if you're trying to get into gigging yourself and getting out there and playing, you may well use these lyrics for years to come. I've had this sheet maybe, 5 or 6 years using it for my gigs, and it makes my my playing so much easier whenever I get out there and play. So I hope you've enjoyed those points that I've given you here with this little lesson. From here, you can continue on to the other video that I've got, which actually gets into the meat of singing and playing at the same time. I'm going to give you some tips there on, what sort of songs to start off with. If you're getting into singing and playing for the very first time, where do you start? What makes an easy song? And how can you make things simpler without compromising the song? All that sort of thing. So I hope to join you, or I hope you join me, for that video. I'll catch you again soon for another lesson.